हेलो गाइस, दिस इज़ अंशुल मेघलानी एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सॉल्व अ प्रॉब्लम इन अ लिंक लिस्ट, अ प्रॉब्लम ऑफ अ लिंक लिस्ट। सो यू ऑल नो व्हाट इज़ अ लिंक लिस्ट। इट इज़ अ नोड लाइक डेटा स्ट्रक्चर इन विच ऑल नोड्स आर कनेक्टेड टू ईच अदर बाय अ एड्रेस। सो दिस नोड इज कनेक्टेड टू अदर बाय एड्रेस। सो वी हैव गिवन अ लिंक लिस्ट कंसिस्टिंग ऑफ सम नंबर्स and we have to delete a node if its right value is bigger. For example, in here we have to delete first node and then we came to second because there are no other nodes, and then check its right value, which is 3, and delete 2 and then do the same for all the nodes, and at final we have 5 and null. So this is a question. Let's take some more examples. In this one we will do the same thing. We take a node and we check its value with its right. If it's smaller or its right node's value is greater, we just delete it and go here, check here, and then it is not smaller, so we don't have to delete 18. Go here, 7 is smaller than 16, 7 is smaller than 16, so delete 7, and just we have to go pointer to here. 16 is bigger than 14, we don't have to do anything, and we just go here, and this is the last node, we don't have to do anything here. So our list will be 18, 16, 14, and then null. One observation which will make your code easier or implementation easier is that after deleting all the values, you have a list which is of in descending order. The list will be in descending order, this is for sure. This is an observation which we have came and which we will use in our next part of code. So let's quickly see this example also. In this example I want to show that if you came to a solution in which just check a pair of nodes, and if the current node is smaller than the next node's value, then delete that node. But this will not work because of this test case in which we will see that if we will follow our intuition, then we will came to a linked list of first we will start from 6 and then we will compare it with 4 and not delete 6. So 6 is here, and then we will go to 4, compare it with 10, and come to and delete 4, and then there is 10. So this will be our linked list, but this is not in descending order. Or by a question, what question says, you have to delete a node which has a greater value on its right. So 6 has a greater value on its right, so you have to delete 6 also. Here you have to delete 6 also, and our final value will be of 10. This is our final linked list will look like. So this intuition which will come in our mind is wrong, because in big of and in simple search we will just comparing a pair of nodes and we will deleting that. That was wrong. So from here also you all have come to our first approach. First approach, what will first approach say? That find you have given a linked list. Find a maximum in this linked list, delete all the nodes before that, and point head to here, and then find maximum in this part, point this node to our maximum, and delete that part. Deleting that part, and then do that operation in other part. Find maximum, point that to that, and delete this part, and go to next part. This is our first approach we will came to know. After that, we have a linked list which value is decreasing linked list. So let's quickly see its code. This is its code. I have initialized. Let's take an example for that. Four, eight, ten, three, five. Okay, that is enough. First, take a temp variable and store head in it, and we will iterate from the temp is equal to start to end. Okay, then take a variable named max and current. A current variable which denotes that where is a current temp is at, the current value which is at. So we will see in our next part of code what current means. And max denotes the max in our linked list. So we will iterate from temp and take a variable named it, and which iterates from temp to end. Okay, and find a maximum element from temp to end. Here it is 10. So it stores in first iteration is temp. Okay, so not it stores, it iterates, and it helps in finding max element, that is 10. So our max now stores 10. What we have to do, I have taken two condition. If h is equal to 0, h is equal to means 0 means we haven't used the head node. This is the first value which we will make our head point to. This is a base case. So in the for that case, I have initialized h is equal to 0, and when h is equal to 0, it will point head to its max and make h is equal to 1. Okay, after that, if that condition holds true in other iterations, it will go to the else statement. In else statement, h is 1. That means head is pointing to a element which is the maximum in this linked list. So in our next iterations, the current is that part, the max element which is currently a max element. After that, we will find a max element in next part, and we will just now this is max. In our next iteration, this is current. What I have do, I have just put current's next is equal to max. I have connected it and just iterate it over and over again. So you all can see this is a big of n square approach, in which temp variable is starting from first head, goes to end, and the it pointer is helping us in finding a max element of the remaining part of a linked list. And temp is not iterating through each value. After we have find a max element, we don't have to iterate to 8. We just let's wait. We point 10 to 3, it's all after finding 10, because these values are not important for us, these all are deleted. So here I have increment the max to the max dot next, that is 3, and store max in temp, max in temp, and then start iterating again, finding max here, and then what I have explained. So this is our first code. This follows as I have discussed, this follows the time complexity of big of n square and space complexity. Let's see the space complexity. We haven't used any type of extra space other than some variables, so its space complexity will be big of 1. As its space complexity is good, but we can improve its time complexity to big of n. So let's now see our second approach. What we are doing, we have given a list of numbers, we are finding a maximum number and deleting all the numbers which are smaller than that, and goes to the next part of our list, and then finding. So after that we are coming up with a decreasing linked list, a linked list which have elements which are in decreasing order. This is, so what we can do is we can first reverse our linked list, second just delete nodes to make our linked list in ascending order, and third reverse it again. Okay, let's understand with this with an example. We can take an example of some nodes like 4. 5, 10, 3, 6. Okay, so what we can do in first step is we can reverse it. It will be 6, 3, 10, 5, 4. Now what we have we are doing is finding a maximum element and deleting all the other elements from its left. So the maximum element is not getting deleted, okay, and the last element in a linked list is in our final linked list, which we have to find a decreasing linked list. So what we can do is our maximum element is not deleted, okay, so 6 our maximum element in this part, okay, 6 consists in our first element is consist in our answer, and then we have to just make it an increasing linked list. We will compare 6 with 3, it is bigger, so we will just points to its next element, points 6 to 10. Now let's t now points to 6. We will compare 6 with 3, t dot next, and if it is bigger, then we will just point t to 10, and we will just point t to 10. Okay, after that we will compare t with its next. It is smaller, then we are going to skip 3, and as this is also smaller than t is equal to 10, we are going to skip this and point that to null. Whatever linked list will look like after that, 6, tan null. And we are going to reverse it again. It's going to tan 6, then null, and this is our answer. As you have seen, that the maximum is 10. Delete all the nodes, this 10, and then here maximum is 6.10.26, and it is answer. So this is our basic algorithm, in which in first part we will reverse it. In second part, we will make it in ascending order, and third part we will reverse it again. So first, initially we will going to see how to reverse a linked list. It is a very very easy code how to reverse a linked list. Null. Okay, so this is a linked list. We are going to need two pointers, or you can say three pointers. First one is current, which points to is here, which will iterate. Second is previous, which points to here, null. As you can also induce that previous is one before the current, and next is here. Next is nothing but just the next pointer in. What we will do is iterate current from start to null and reverse its direction. We will just, as it is initially points to here, and after iterating from here to here, it will just reverse its direction. So what is the algorithm? We will store current dot next in next. Okay, we have stored a next pointer for and at the end point current is equal to next at each iterator, and just we have increased the current, and in middle part we have to change our links. So how to change a link? In current dot next, current dot next points to previous, and other is incrementing a previous to current. This is a very easy implementation in which now current points to here. No, sorry. Let's the color. Now previous points to here. This is previous, and current points to here. And our linked list is reversed for that node. Okay. And previous, as this node is disconnected from this, so for that we have taken a previous value which stores that node which is disconnected from others, and do the same for all the other nodes. We have a linked list which is reversed, and at the end we will return previous. At end will point to last node. We will return previous. So this is a basic code for reversal linked list. Now for our main code, what we will do, we have given a compute function. We have to write a compute function only. Initially I have reversed the linked list. From head and store its head in a header itself. So after, for take an example, 4, 5, 6, 10, 3. Okay, 3, 7. After that, our linked list will be like, at first step, it will be like here. After reversing, it will be like null. इट विल बी लाइक 7, 3, 10, 6, 5, 4 and null. Okay, and what I am doing after that is storing current head in current, max node in also max node, and temp. What I am doing is current. I am incrementing current from starting to end, and after in incrementation, I have just checked if this node is. Take one second. If this node is smaller than this one, I have just increased, just skip that, free that, and increase my current to here. I have to check from now. Our max node is 10. Let's take an example from node like that. Our current dot next dot data 3. 3 is data. 3 is less than max node dot data. Max node is 7. 3 is less than 7. Okay, so it is true. Then I have just stored temp 7 3 in temp. To delete this, only for deleting I have used temp here, and after in this currents dot next, currents dot next is equal to temp dot next. Temp is current. Just connect this. I have by this line. It means I have just connect 7 with 10. 7's next now points to 10. Temp dot next is 10. So what I have done is here, and it is 6 now. Yes. So if this condition holds that this is greater than this next, then I have done this. So in our next code, our this is. Next iteration, I will point max node is 10. Will compare this and delete this and points to this. I will compare this with 10 with 5, delete 5. Now 10 points to 4. I will compare 10 with 4, delete 4 because 4 is smaller. I will next iterate to null. At null, when we reaches at null, we have our linked list, which is in increasing order strictly, and after that we will just reverse 4, 10, 7 and null, and we will just return head, that is 10. So this is a very basic code for that, and let's discuss a time complexity. As there is only one loop and current is starting from 7 and goes to the end, and reverse a linked list also consists of only a one loop. So this will consist of big of n. This part is also big of n, and this is big of n as we have discussed. So time complexity is 3 into big of n, or just we can say big of n. Let's now see her space complexity. We have used only some variables here, so nothing else, nothing array, nothing another data structure. Also in our reverse links function we have used only some variables for traversing, so its space complexity is also big of 1. like previous one. This is our optimal solution. And we have another solution, another approach, which is a recursive one. Let's now discuss it quickly. Approach T, which is a recursive one. So in this approach, we will recursively, we have given a linked list, and we will recursively travel to the last node and compare it with the previous one. We will go to the last node recursively, and while coming back, we will compare this with this. And if this is smaller, like in previous code, we are comparing. Let me explain. We are comparing reverse after reversing. We are comparing this with this, and if this is smaller, we are just skipping this and deleting this. Okay. Same thing we are doing here. After coming back, we are comparing this and this. If this is smaller, then we are going to ignore this and just look at that one and compare this with this while coming back. So this is our basic code, basic logic, and we will see its code. When head compute head here, it is our recursive call. For example, 1, 2, 3, 4 null. We will see head points to here. It does not point null, so we will just call recursively. Go here, null. Return. Go here, and then go here. While coming back, we will just compare this. We are going to compare this code is while coming back. After that, we will just see because temp here stores null, because head is null. So we will just compare temp's data. Temp's data is zero. Null's data is zero. So if zero is greater than temp's data, it is not. We will just return temp. Temp is here is 4. So else we will return head and points heads next to temp. Okay. So we are going to do this for this example. Done. Now temp is 4. And after that, we will come to 4 is our linked list. This is our linked list because these all are ignored. At the end, the head will point to this. Sorry, this. Let me explain more. For example, 4. We are given, let's take an example so that 5, 4, 3, 10, 6 and 7. So here answer will be 10 and 7 10 to 7. Okay. What are we going to do? Recursively, we reaches at the end. At end and a null. Here temp points to null and head points to here. We will compare this, and if this is smaller, this is greater than that, we will just point temp to here. We will do nothing, just point temp to here, and we will compare with this. Nothing, it is smaller, not this is smaller. If compare this to head with temp, head is here initially, now head is here. My black color will denotes an head. Black color will denote head. Head is now here. So we will compare 6 with temp. If head's data is greater than temp, head's data is greater than temp. So we will go to here and we will just, but it is not, we will just ignore it. And now head is here, my head is here. I will compare head with the head's data with temp's data. It is here. Now I will point temp to here. My temp is here. And I have changed a link. I will just erase this. And after this, I will compare temp with head. Our new head. New head is here. It is smaller. Do nothing. It is smaller. Do nothing. It is smaller. Do nothing. Now head points, and we will return this. Our return this. Now what is answer? 10,7. Okay, this we have done here. If head's data is less than temp's data, we will just return temp, and if not, we are making head's next to temp. Head's next head here, next, sorry, let me change head's next to temp, changing the links, and we will return. This is our recursive code. So thank you for listening till here, and I am going to attach a document which consists of all the codes which I have discussed. If you have some problem, you can refer to that document also. Thank you. This is from my side. I am Anshul Miglani from Geeksman. We will see you later. Thank you.